Songs, I guess, we do it as people of yore did it. Some experience occurred, some personal experience for them to put into words. It's kind of a divine inspiration. And this is probably a good lead-in to refer to a relative, Louise Alley here, whose mother and father collaborated on the tribe's flag song. And right now, I want to ask her for her own input. You know, tell us what you remember about it in your own words. It was a great tribute that seemingly was missing, and she sensed it and wanted to do something about it. She was had a fine ear for music, from what we recall. I think you had referred to it briefly at another session, but for purposes of the review, will you please tell us about your memories of your mother and your father and composition of the tribal flag song?
I'm sorry, I can't sing like I used to. They say you sing when you're happy, but I haven't been happy. This morning when you called me, I went to my bedroom and I just prayed. I asked Wakanda to give me that strength. It's been a 43 years since my mother left me. It's been over 20 years since my dad left me. My mother really thought a lot of Oto people. She had respect for everybody. She was a little orphan girl when she was 2 years old. She said her mother passed away. Her father, my grandfather, John Charles, took care of my mother till he got married to Grandma Edith. My mother always tell, it's not easy to have a stepmother. So I was glad when I was old enough to go to school. They put her in school here at Oto. And after she got older, where they sent her to Chilocco. My mother was in the first graduating class at Chilocco. We used to have that picture of her graduating class, but since our home burned in 1939, we lost all our pictures. I had so much to learn from my mother. She left me when she was only 65 years old. Even today, I miss my mother. She used to always tell my sister and I, be good to people, make friends, have a lot of friends. And today I experience that. I've got friends everywhere. People are good to me. But this song, been thinking about the Indian people. Seemed like no tribe had a flag song until the Otoes had their flag song. It's in the 20s somewhere in there when my mother composed the song, because it's before Uncle Morgan died, and I think he passed away in 1930. We were camped down here at the powwow ground. My mother fixed a meal, invited all the singers. She sang that flag song for them. and they learned it. Uncle Morgan was really proud of my mother for composing that song. I think it's an honor when a woman, you know. My mother dreamed that song. I'll never forget when she first sang that song. Like I said, I'm sorry, I can't even carry a tune. I can't even sing at church. I could hum it, but I just prayed about it this morning. Wakanda might help me. I remember the song. They made another song, the prayer song. I sang that this morning, pretty good. She made several individual songs, but like I told Jimmy on the road, the only Grandpa Corbett White song is, I've heard it sung a few times, but the other songs are all lost. We had no recorders those days, and I regret it because most of those songs are lost. I think my little uncle, Emmanuel Black, does well. He sings the flag song. Just wish he was here, he could help me. My best. I can't sing.
All right, thank you. Go to the